Today I'm going to show you a slow motion hack in DaVinci Resolve with practically any camera. Now I know there's some M50 owners out there, and the only way you can get slow motion really is to shoot 60 frames per second, slow it down, but you can shoot 120 frames per second on the Canon M50. It's just now your resolution is lower to 720p and you also lose autofocus on it. So here we are in Resolve with a little clip that I'm going to use for a project. And for whatever reason, I blanked out. I was shooting it in 30 frames per second when I should have been shooting it in 60 frames per second to slow it down later. And when I play this now, you're going to see there's a little jerkiness to it. See that? How it kind of stutters? What you could do is go into your inspector and find retime and scaling. And under retime process, if you change this to optical flow, so what this does, it smoothens out that jerkiness by adding additional frames to the footage. So now if I play it, you're gonna see it's less jerky. See, you still see it a little bit, but it's a lot better than where it was before. So now let's get to the slow motion part. So if you go Control R, or if you right click over the footage and look for retime controls, now your footage can look like this. I'm gonna expand this a little bit. Now you're gonna see here, the 100% means that the clip is being played at 100%. And to change the speed here, we can do it from here and change it to something like 50% to slow it down, right? So now if we play this, you're gonna see it's gonna smoothen out a lot more. Now it's still not buttery smooth, but it's a lot better from when we first started. You could enhance this more by trying these options here. So motion estimation, typically I would use enhance better. It does make my footage look choppy though if I play it, but when you render it, it actually looks pretty good. Now the last option I would recommend doing, again, this is only if you're super desperate, is to use the speed warp option here. Now the reason why I say this is a last resort method, this is gonna bog down your system because it's so system reliant, unless you have a beast of a computer. And then the other downside of using this option is it takes so long to render even just 10 seconds of footage. That could take 10 or 15 minutes. So I'm gonna show you how this optical flow looks like when it's rendered. Now, as much as this is a great technique to use that'll kind of save your butt, it's very important that you only use this very sparingly. And it's more important for you to have a shot list to know and kind of think in your head, what are the shots that I want? And that way you're not kind of just second guessing yourself or experimenting. You should always have a foundation of what your shot list is going to be. Now, if you like this kind of thing, make sure you leave me a thumbs up and a comment below what you thought of this technique. I'm going to be covering editing to music in the next DaVinci Resolve tutorial. Still very basic, still very beginner-centric. If you haven't caught the beginner tutorials, I'll be sure to leave them on the end screen. And yeah, we'll see you soon. Hollywood heart, but it's hard to give it my trust, 'cause